Sam, the killing of Iran's top nuclear scientist could fuel more tensions between Tehran and Washington. We're watching it unfold on the streets of Iran's capital. That relationship has deteriorated rapidly since Trump took office, by design mostly. Give us a sense of how significant this is and the impact that it has on national security.
Well, Boris, we're here because of Trump's failed Iran policy. Trump withdrew from the nuclear deal, and Iran resumed banned activities. Because diplomacy has been dead, there has been an increased reliance on covert operations. That's a backstory here. And when we look at the impact in Iran, let's remember, in addition to his current role, the target of this attack also is a human library of historical information with respect to Iran's nuclear program. So his death is a loss in that regard. And as Alex just mentioned, the string of sabotage operations and assassinations that Iran has suffered over the past several months are a black eye to the regime security-wise. That's why it is likely that Iran will not take this lying down. But I anticipate that Iran may have more of a calibrated response. President Rouhani said earlier that Iran won't be trapped into creating chaos. I think that's because President Rouhani has his eye on the prize, which is sanctions relief. Sanctions relief is only possible via negotiation with the United States. And I don't think that Rouhani wants to do anything to undermine the prospects for negotiations under a Biden administration.
Now, turning to the Biden transition, on Monday, it's going to be the first day that President-elect Joe Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala Harris are going to get their first presidential daily briefing. From your perspective, how significant is that?
Well, the PDB refers both to a written document and an oral briefing. The written document is provided by the Director of National Intelligence to the president every day. It's often accompanied by an oral briefing in which the president and anyone else in the room can ask questions and dig deeper. Now, remember, when it comes to Vice President Biden, he's not going to have a steep learning curve when it comes to intelligence. He received the PDB when he was vice president and participated in that oral briefing. And unlike President Trump, the PDB is not going to be if I feel like it kind of activity. In my experience with then Vice President Biden, the PDB was a must do. Now, based on the fact that the president-elect will be receiving the PDB several weeks before inauguration, he'll have an opportunity to get more fully informed on classified threats and opportunities, as well as potentially covert capabilities. So for all those reasons, Boris, we will have a president that's operating with more intelligence after January 20th.
And Biden is also soon going to have to decide whether to share transcripts of presidential calls with foreign leaders to a broad security clearance holding audience or maintain a lockdown of those transcripts and other sensitive information. Basically, a policy that was imposed by the Trump administration. What do you think Biden is going to do?
Well, we're talking about information that's stored on a code word server. Code word is a term that's used to refer to a specific category of information that is classified at a certain level based on its sensitivity. The Trump team stored information on this code word server that was not at a code word classification level. They did that to restrict access and arguably to avoid embarrassment to the president. The Biden team will probably operate based on the letter of the law. Accessing classified information is based on two things, having an appropriate security clearance and having a need to know that information. I would expect the Biden administration to meet those two requirements when they think about sharing this information. The key factor here is the need to know what is in those transcripts, and that will determine, I think, how widely this information is shared.
All right, Samantha Vinograd, thank you so much. Hope you have a good weekend.
Thank you.